Again, some other examples of mass mobilization. The waterman of India, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Dr. Rajendra Singh, is running a lot of campaigns in Rajasthan. He's making tankas and all and really inspiring the people. That is a grassroots level example. He's a very humble person and I've had the opportunity to meet him. Again, another one of the example of the traditional water harvesting techniques apart from the textbooks we just read is called spring reformation. Very basic. When the rainfall hits the mountain, there are water droplets which seep into the soil. So there is one source which comes outside and which collects all the droplets, all the seepage, and you can collect that water. If you can find that source at the end of the mountain, at the base, you can collect that water and it is pure water. So that's a really good technique. It's called spring reformation. Stressing about more issues, the education system. Okay. Now this one is really, really paradoxical, paranoid. We Indian students are letting ministers make laws for us. Ministers who are not even studied like till class 8. And they are making laws for the students of college. That's really bad. Every 2-3 years, they have to change the laws. Why? Well, they don't want the tuitions to survive. Okay. So now you have, you know, compiled all the examinations to one common exam. The CAT and the, everything is just being combined to one exam. All the engineering examinations. So you get that one examination in the system. Okay, very good. Very good for the students, yeah. So don't you think the tuition center will come up for that particular exam only? Rather, the competition would be intense, more intense. Only a marginal students give, you know, board exams or something like that, you know. Only the commerce students like me, 100%. If you have one entrance exam, what would happen? Commerce, arts, humanities. All the students would come together for that one exam. 100% would not be a cutoff then. It would be a base level cutoff. Like, it's like 0%. Cutoffs would not be there because so many children are there, we need to realize. Okay, so what we can do with this is education. We need the value-based education. Because if you have the value-based education, if you have a pragmatic approach towards education, you will never ever produce marks. You will never ever produce education. You will provide excellence. That is the word. You will provide excellence, not education. That has to be incumbent to the system. And what we can do to ensure is that we have to voice that we don't need education. We need excellence. Some last points that we hear politicians squabbling over issues. And I think even Jerry Bhaiya would agree when I say that policies are just an idea. Okay, so you know, people start getting agitated over the environmental issues and all those things, and the ministries respond, the UN responds by saying, oh yeah, we'll ratify the UN Kyoto Protocol, blah blah and blah, but nothing will happen. So we really need to work over ourselves, because nothing can be done by big people. What we can do is by ourselves, by one person each. Because as one, we are a drop, as together, we are an ocean. In this August gathering preceding me, many visionaries have put forward a plethora of remedies, solutions. Although I'm a young, eclectic student, but I would like to emphasize that we, youth, are the future of today. So we can only work towards achieving the Millennium Development Goals. I'll just quote my inspiration. That's always what just inspires me, something philosophical. If you have the belief to choose your road, if you have the courage to stay on it, if you have the conviction to surmount the rough stretches. If you do, you will find that the road begins to follow you. So thank you for bearing with me, and let us aspire to inspire.
Thank you, Ankur. So we started the morning with a 12-year-old who's now probably a 32-year-old, and we end the conclude the session with a 17-year-old who's given us some wonderful thoughts. I see a Kapil Sibal in the making. He'll be environment minister and then the education minister. I didn't mean the other the negative attributes of Kapil Sibal. Okay, great.
I'm going to take an autograph today.
Thank you, Ankur. So we'll open the floor. We have 10 minutes. We were planning an open house today, but we are running late. And the open house was on corrupt leaders are direct manifestation of corrupt citizens. So if there are any reflections on the panel on this particular topic, which was to be the open house, please feel free to share your thoughts. 10 minutes for that, and then we break for tea, and then we'll have the Karmaveer Chakra ceremony.